Hey, what's up, guys? David Glenn of DavidGlennRecording.com and ThePRoAudioFiles.com. I'm excited because I'm going to switch gears a little bit today, and a lot of us are mixing engineers, and that's awesome, up-and-coming mixers, that sort of thing. But today, you're going to learn something still, I think, but I'm going to direct this more at artists, recording themselves, producers looking to tighten up their rough mix, and I'm going to take you step-by-step pretty quickly and show you how you can quickly get a solid rough mix of your vocals. So I'm going to use this with one. I'm going to do this with one plugin. I'm going to use Isotope Nectar 2, and we'll get to that in a minute. Right now, the first thing I want to do is I just want to listen to the vocal. This is a song called "Thanks for Breakfast." It's by the artist Jessica Ripka. Jessica has been kind enough to actually open up her whole archive of songs, and she's got all the session files. And I reached out to her, became a fan, and she said yes. So we're going to use some of her stuff. Hope you love it. And don't forget to check her out and support her over at jessicaripka.com. Moving on, we've got her vocal. We're going to hit play, see everything set here. Plug in, we're just going to bypass for now and take a listen.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. Without you.
Okay, cool. So it sounds to have been recorded well. The only complaint I have is it was recorded kind of hot. And so looking over at the meter, you'll see it's good practice to Kenny Joya has a great tutorial over at Groove 3 where he handles recording vocals. And something he said was to make sure you record at kind of like a minus 18. And you can change your meters in Pro Tools whenever you do that. But try to keep your peaks, even your peaks, from getting above kind of the halfway point. You don't want anything jumping up above that. If you want to record, maybe your verse is softer at a different preamp level and then your other at another, that's great. But nowadays with 24-bit recording and the converters that we have and everything, you don't need to record hotter than your peaks hitting it about halfway. That's kind of crazy. So the first thing I'm going to do with this, I'm going to use clip gain, and I'm going to bring down probably 6-7 dB. Let's see right about there, and let's see what we get.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and—
okay, still a little bit hot, but I can work with that. So lead vocals, we want to sit on top. It's going to be louder than everything else anyway. So moving on, I'm going to open up Isotopes Nectar. Like I said, it sounded like this was recorded with a good mic and in a treated space. I don't hear any room sound, which is incredible. And I've been plagued with mixes that have some pretty terrible room noise in them. So that's, I'm super thankful for that. The first thing I'm going to look at is I'm going to look at some saturation, just kind of pull in some character to this. And then I'm just going to work. You watch me and then try out what I'm doing. I'll try to talk a little bit in between and we'll go from there.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Let's see what happens when I push this.
Without you, without you. I bought a house and filled it without you.
It actually doesn't sound too bad.
Bought a car and kept it.
It's pretty subtle, but you can hear it kind of filling the vocal out a little bit. Let's bypass that.
I bought a house
Here's
and
in.
Filled it without you. I bought a house and filled it. Without you. I bought a house and filled it.
Okay, so it's subtle, but it's kind of lifting the vocal a little bit, giving it a little bit of oomph. Let's pull up in an EQ. I don't hear any low end that needs to be filtered out, but I'm pretty OCD when it comes to my my low end being filtered out on vocals, so I'm going to go ahead and do it.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Cool. And what that's going to do, that's going to remove any air conditioning, rumble, any kind of low noise, bumping the mic with their foot or anything like that. Any kind of accidents that happen. A lot of times we're not recording with pop filters or shock mounts, and so that can really help to cut the rumble out, but we don't really need anything. I get in the habit of saying I've released a tutorial all about mixing vocals over at mixingvocals.com, and I mentioned that I'm finding more and more that in modern mixes, I'm not really needing much below 150. I'm cutting most, if not all, below that out anyways, and then using kind of 125 to 200 for the warmth or for the fullness in a vocal, for the chestiness. So anyways, just kind of cut out some of those lows. I'm going to move on to some compression.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Okay, so for this first compressor, I'm looking to limit the peaks, to just kind of smack those. For rough vocal sounds, I'm not going to worry too much about the attack. You see here that this has got kind of a fast attack. It's got a pretty quick release, and that's just going to kind of smack it down, get it out of the way, and move on. But I will elaborate more on that on some more vocal, you know, driven, really deep tutorials. Moving on, I'm going to actually add a compressor to this so we can use two in parallel.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it without you.
Okay, so this over here is kind of a mix knob between the first set of compressor, the first compressor and the second compressor. And I've got it about halfway, so we're parallel compressing there. And that ratio, I'm thinking, could come up a little bit.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Okay, so we're tightening that up a little bit. That's quite a bit of compression. We're going to move on and see. I don't know if this needs any de-essing, but once I limit it, I have a feeling that we're going to want a little bit of a de-esser. And I like to use this. I love the limiter. This would be equivalent to like an L1 if you had a Waves bundle.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you.
Okay, I'm going to try something. We're not seeing any gain reduction because the level, we pulled that down and I didn't drive this in. I'm going to pull this down almost all the way and I'm going to see if I can tap into a little bit of reduction.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it.
Okay, now let's hear before and after it where we're at right now. So here I'm going to bypass it.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it.
And then with it.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Yeah, very cool. So not too bad on the compression. We're definitely leveling it out. We're balancing it, getting it kind of not necessarily pop smashed in my face, but it's going to help me to understand it a little bit better, especially for a rough mix, to be able to be communicated to the mixing engineer. I'm hearing we may need a little bit of de-essing, not much, just to kind of touch it. We're not really boosting too much of the top end, which we could. Let's try that.
I bought a house and filled it without you.
That's not bad.
Bought a car and kept it without you.
Now we can touch it with a de-esser.
Without you. I bought a house and filled it.
Yeah. Let's hear it without the de-esser.
I bought a house and filled it.
You hear that S?
I bought a house and filled it.
Cool. That just kind of tames it a little bit. Just a quick de-esser. Let's move on. Let's add some effects. I'm a big fan of some gentle chorus with my lead vocals, just to kind of blend it into where I feel it kind of start to shape the vocal, but I don't want to hear it. I'm going to boost it up to where I do hear it, then I'm going to back it down.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it.
Very cool. So now we just kind of feel it. You heard it kind of ringing on us. Then I backed it down and just kind of feel it. So let me bypass it.
I bought a house and filled it without you. I bought a house and filled it without you.
Very cool. I could use a little bit less. Moving on. Let's put maybe a little slap delay. I don't know if it works for this song. I like to start around 90 milliseconds. 90 to 120 sometimes will be the sweet spot. And we're going to play with that. Let's see. I like modulating things. Let's go with 0.25. Let's see if it'll give me that. Okay, 0.2. And let's boost the depth. So by a lower rate, we can drive it harder depth-wise. And it'll be much softer, smoother sound. So we're almost modulating this a little bit as well, getting a chorusing sound.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it without you.
Okay, so I could use a little bit less of that, but let's hear before and after.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it.
Yeah, so just kind of gives her a little bit of a space. Not your John Lennon slap by any means, but just kind of pushes it back a little bit and gives a little bit of a dimension. Let's throw a little bit of verb and see what we can do with this. Let's pull the wetness up. And sure, let's see what this does.
I bought a house and filled it without you.
Okay, so I'm already not a huge fan of reverb. I have to be really careful when I'm using reverb. It's usually just for a stylistic, the client comes to me and says, hey, I want it to sound like this, and then there's lots of reverb on it, and I'll match that. Or I do a lot of work with reverbs where you feel them but don't really hear them. In this case, this is one you're hearing. Pretty obvious. So what I want to do is I want to try to create some separation between the vocalist and the reverb, the reflections. And what I'm going to do, how I'm going to do that is I'm going to use pre-delay. And what's great about iZotope, you don't have to think about all this other stuff. You just follow a tutorial like this and you can really dial in a tight vocal sound. Let's go ahead and set some pre-delay. It's probably worth mentioning that you can dial in a pretty strict pre-delay to your rhythm, to the tempo. This is actually not track to a click, but it's about 79 beats per minute. I tapped it in, and what you can do, there's an app called Producer's Tools, and I use this a lot for, I just mentioned it in another tutorial about using R-Bass and pulling up the frequency translator. For this, I'm going to pull up in a delay calculator, and I'm going to go to about 79 beats per minute. And I'm going to scroll through and see what like a 64th note would be, 47.47 milliseconds. So I'm going to go to around 50 milliseconds, and I'm going to see if that creates a nice little separation between the vocalist and the reverb sound. Let's hear that.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it.
The other thing to listen for, whenever you're dealing with decay, a good rule of thumb would be to listen for the decay to start on the one and end by the next phrase. So think about it in rhythmic way. In the rhythmic way would be your snare drum. Thought up. So that between those two snare hits, think about your decay starting and ending before the next hit. Kind of timing your reverb to the track so that you can keep it from getting too muddy and getting too washy and kind of going all over the place. So let's take a listen to that and see if we've got the decay set about right.
I bought a house and filled it without you.
See, it would get really washy. Cool. So that's actually not too bad because the song kind of lends itself to that trailing reverb. So then what I want to do, this is way too much. I'm going to pull this all the way down and I'm just going to blend it in until we start to feel it rather than hear it.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Very cool. So I kind of like where the reverb's at, but I hear it a little bit too much. So what I'm going to do is the beautiful thing about Nectar is it's got a built-in analyzer and it's got these filters. We've got a low cut, high pass, and we have a high cut, low pass. And so we can drag these until the reverb starts to feel the way we want it. I feel like there's a little bit too much low end in the reverb, so I'm going to filter that out. So let's take a listen and just slide that up until it feels good. And actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to boost the reverb so it's exaggerated.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it.
Okay, cool. So now I'm feeling like the low end's a little bit tighter, but the top end's a little bit too bright. It's taking my attention away from the vocalist and the top end that's in her voice. So I'm gonna pull some of that out.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you. Without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it. Without you.
Yeah, it started to feel the breath and without you coming back into the reverb up there, and I didn't like that. So now we've kind of got the reverb tightened up. Let's blend that into the track from zero.
I bought a house and filled it without you. Bought a car and kept it without you.
Very cool. Now let's turn it off and let's hear it before and after.
I bought a house and filled it without you. I bought a house and filled it without you.
Very cool. Just a nice, gentle touch of reverb, and it serves the track well. So now let's hear what we've done. Have we accomplished our goal of getting a solid, rough vocal in so that we can better prepare that for the mixing engineer? Let's see. Let's bypass it.
I bought a house and filled it. Without you. Bought a car and kept it. Without you. Without you. Without you. I bought a house and filled it. Without you. Bought a car and kept it.
Very cool. I think we did a great job. Let's see, volume wise.
I bought a house. I bought a house and I bought a house and filled it without you.
Very cool. So we've leveled it out. We've given it a little bit of character. It's more enjoyable to listen to. So while we're kind of getting the balances and working on a rough mix, you're printing that for your artist to take home to listen to it. It's a great way to tighten up the vocal sound. We've got one plugin instantiated for this. And if you're more advanced in that, feel free to check out mixingvocals.com, where I'm going to walk you through top to bottom, A to Z, mixing vocals from gain staging to cleanup to fixing vocals that recorded in a poorly treated room or not treated room. All that good stuff, but much more to come on mixing vocals and David Glenn recording. As always, check out theproaudiophiles.com for incredible content, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.